My dear student, now I want to discuss another theorem or another property. Sin x is equal to y. If sin x is equal to y, then x is equal to n pi plus minus 1 to the power n into y, where n belongs z. Sin x is equal to sin y. If sin x is equal to sin y, then x is equal to n pi plus minus 1 to the power n into y, n belongs z or I. So, how will you prove it? Now, we have sin x is equal to sin y. And you know, proof is very easy. By the transposing term of sin y from right to left, it is sin x minus sin y is equal to 0. And it is 2 cos x plus y by 2 into sin x minus y by 2 is equal to 0. Now, this expression is product of two terms. Cos x plus y by 2 is equal to 0 and sin x minus y by 2 is equal to 0. When cos x plus y by 2 is equal to 0, what do you observe? When cos x plus y by 2 is equal to 0, then the value of x plus y by 2 is the odd multiple of pi by 2. You know it. So we can write, just you observed earlier, when cos theta is equal to 0, then theta is equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. So I want to apply this result in this place, cos x plus y by 2 is equal to 0 is equal to, then we write x plus y by 2 is equal to 2m plus 1 into pi by 2, m belongs to 0. Or x is equal to 2m plus 1 into pi minus y. So, again when x minus y, sin x minus y by 2 is equal to 0, then the value of x minus y by 2 we write here. P pi. Instead of n we write P pi. So, P belongs to Z. Now we have two results. X plus y is equal to 2m plus 1 into pi. M belongs to Z. And also x is equal to 2m plus 1 into pi minus y. And here x minus y is equal to 2p pi. So x is equal to 2p pi plus y. P belongs to Z. So in this way, what do we observe? We have two equations. Equation first is here. And perhaps I wrote this equation two times here. So you do not take it. Now x minus y is equal to 2p pi. X is equal to 2p pi plus y. So we have two equations. One is x is equal to 2m plus 1 into pi minus y. And other is x is equal to 2p pi plus y, p belongs to z. So by combining these two results, we have x is equal to n pi plus minus 1 to the power n into y. N belongs z, which is the general solution of the equation. Which is the general solution of the equation. If sin x is equal to sin y, then general solution will be x is equal to n pi plus minus 1 to the power n into y, n belongs to z. I hope you have followed me. Here, now, I want to discuss by taking help of sin x is equal to sin y. The sin x is equal to y. Now we can derive the general equation of cosec x is equal to cosec y. Now, instead of cosec x, we can write 1 by sin x. And instead of cosec y, you can write 1 by sin y. And this is nothing but sin x is equal to sin y. So, it will be equal to x is equal to n pi plus minus 1 to the power n into y, where n belongs to z. My dear student, you should do here a smart labor. And after deriving the, solving the equation of sin x is equal to sin y, the general value of x is n pi plus minus 1 to the power n into y. Now, you can observe that the value of cosec x is equal to cosec y is equal to is same. So, in this way, we can get the result of the equation sin x is equal to sin y. Now, we want to solve this result cos x is equal to cos y. And the general value of x is 2n pi plus minus y. N belongs to z. If cos x is equal to cos y, then the general value of x is equal to 2n pi plus minus y, n belongs to z. We have cos x is equal to cos y. And cos x minus cos y is equal to 0. And after applying sin cos c minus cos d formula, we have minus 2 sin x plus y by 2 into sin x minus y by 2 is equal to 0. So now, what do we observe? The product of these two factors is 0. This implies sin x plus y by 2 is equal to 0. Or sin x minus y by 2 is equal to 0. So when sin theta is equal to 0, then theta is equal to m pi, m belongs to z. And when this sin theta minus y is equal to 0, then we have also x is equal to 2p pi plus y. And here, x is equal to 2m pi minus y. Here there are two results, two values of x. And by combining these two results, we can get the value of x is equal to 2n pi plus minus y, where n belongs to z, which is the general solution of the equation. Now, by same fashion, by same method, cos x is equal to cos y. It is 1 by sec x, 1 by sec y. It is sec x is equal to sec y. And you know that the value of x is equal to 2n pi plus minus y when n belongs z. Now, you can write cos x is equal to cos y, sec x is equal to sec y. So, in this way you can, here sec x is equal to sec y. You take its reciprocal 1y cos x is equal to 1y cos y. So, this is nothing but cos x is equal to cos y. So, sec x is equal to sec y can be written as cos x is equal to cos y. And when cos x is equal to cos y, then x is equal to 2n pi plus minus y, n belongs to z. We have just proved it. Dear student, by the same labor, by same effort, by common efforts, we can solve these two results. Now, see, when 10x is equal to 10y, when 10x is equal to 10y, where if x and y are not odd multiples of pi by 2, here there is a restriction. 10x is equal to 10y. Here, and x and y will not be the odd multiple of pi by 2. Then the value of 10x is equal to n pi plus y. N pi plus y. See here. 10x is the ratio of sin x by cos x. 10y is the ratio of sin y by cos y. And after doing cross multiplication, we have sin x into cos y. And sin y into cos x. And this is equal to sin x into cos y minus sin y into cos x. And this is equal to sin of angle x minus y is equal to 0. And when sin theta is equal to 0, then theta is equal to n pi, n belongs to z. So we have x is equal to n pi plus y when n belongs to z, which is the general solution of the equation 10x is equal to 10y. When 10x is equal to 10y, then x is equal to n pi plus y.